really handy if you could do that.
Sweet.
Okay. So yeah, I did watch the replays.
Yep.
And they were somewhat good in terms of yes, I can work with that. As you already mentioned, your macro slips quite hard sometimes.
Yeah.
Like really hard.
Yeah. Yeah, that macro is so confusing to me.
Yes, you were a Zerg, right? So.
Yeah, I was a Zerg, and even though Zerg is like more macro focused, I feel like it's easier. I don't know, for me at least.
Yeah, Terran macro is different. A Zerg, I don't know. You have the larva inject. That's important. The creep spread, but you had specific timings where you just now I make 20 drones. Bam! Now I make 40 Zerglings. Bam!
Yeah, yeah.
And as
and
Terran,
with Zerg, like you can kind of just do it. Like muscle memory, like injecting was is so built into me that I can do it on time without even thinking about it. You know.
Yes. That's the same for me with muling, basically, and just basically it's the same, but I know it's very different. If I would switch now to Zerg and getting used to injects and creep spread constantly, that it takes a lot of time to get used to it.
Yeah,
it's somewhat different.
I'm hoping to get used to the muling and scanning and making SCVs and shit for Terran.
Yes.
It's just the whole queuing up units is so strange to me.
Yeah, basically you should never queue up more than two units.
Two.
Yes.
Yeah, I get that. I probably don't do it, but I understand. I've been told.
Yes.
And I've seen people say.
I mean, there are sometimes for me as well if I play against Protoss, for example. And I know, okay, I need to produce more Marauder, and I just have one barracks with a tech lab. Then I queue up lots of Marauder, and suddenly I have 5 Marauder queued in one barracks, which is 400 minerals, which could be a command center building right now.
Or it could be 2 or 3 more barracks.
Yeah, exactly. So that's, but yeah, if you go in, we go in and we can fix that, I guess.
Yeah.
It helps a lot if you manage your control groups.
Yeah.
And there's also a trick I can show you for constant supply depot production.
Oh, really? That'd be cool.
Yes.
Supply depots are definitely, out of the three races, Terran have the hardest time, in my opinion. Easily.
Okay.
Supply depots build so slowly. So slowly.
Yeah, as Terran, you just need to do everything the whole time, basically.
Yeah.
Like, as Protoss, as Protoss, it feels like, okay, you add 6 gates now, and then every 30 seconds you just make a huge warp in. So you can float 1k minerals, it's okay if you have the gates for it. As Terran, you don't have instant warp in. That's...
No. Meh. Nothing is instant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, you are online, right? No, yes,
yeah,
maybe?
Yeah, on the European server. Dropout 11411.
114. Oh, you have 5 numbers?
Yeah. I noticed that accounts now have 5 numbers.
Okay, I have 4.
I have like a trillion accounts.
Lol. Okay, now I invite you to a party. Bams. Okay. And then we go into the first replay and just talk a little bit and see what's going on.
Sweet. It's another thing, like, the reason why I want to play Terran is, A, I like to micro, and it, like, I feel better when I micro than when I win with Zerg from just macroing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I love micro, and I love watching people micro with, like, Marines and Medivacs and Marauders. And
okay.
I love the dropping, and, you know, so I guess I kind of forget about the base management a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, I remember this game like exactly now.
Yeah. I know why. Yeah.
But to be fair, every game I've had against Protoss in the last while has been very similar. I just usually have won. But
I noticed you win with like one heavy drop or attack while somewhat defending, but later on if you hit better player, that's not how it will work anymore, because they will be able to either crush you or defend at home, and then you're way behind if your macro slips.
Yeah.
against platinum and diamonds, that might work. Against master, can get difficult already, depending on how good you execute your attacks. I find it good that you think Terran is indeed a bit hard to play with constant production. That definitely is the way I feel sometimes as well. As Zerg, I have highly respect for the guys who never miss creep spread or inject, because that's so difficult. But in my opinion, getting a good attack as a Zerg is not as difficult as with maybe Terran or Protoss. If you get a good flank, concave.
It's very simple, I feel. You set up
the attack and then you do it. And remax behind, attack again. Basically, that's the idea.
And counterattacking in Little Harass's Zerg is very straightforward. It's like throw Lings at a base. Run in with Muter and Muter Micro, which is pretty.
Muter Micro is hard. So good Muter, especially if you clump the Muter to a flock and focus fire with them, so you know you don't lose them. That's difficult in my opinion. But yeah,
they're the most fun unit Zerg has in my opinion.
The Mutalisk, yes,
the most fun.
Yeah.
Terran has so much more units like that I'd rather use.
Terran has so much potential to deal damage, but they need to deal damage in order to keep up with the rest of the races. So that's the payoff.
They don't have as like with Protoss and Chronoboost, they can get out so many probes, you know?
Yeah.
And with Zerg, obviously with Lava, they can get out infinite number of drones in 10 seconds.
Yeah, that's that. as Zerg, you need to deal damage to force them not making drones.
Yeah, and you need to missing use creep. The lava to make units.
Yeah, so right.
Yeah.
And then you need to trade those units as best as you can.
Trade?
But okay. Yeah, not really trade. I mean, as a Terran, you want to kill those units you forced without losing any. That's what the drops are for.
Right.
But that's sometimes difficult. What I noticed, I just had another student today, and he was wasting units. He was throwing units away. And back at home, he didn't macro. So that's the thing. If you deal damage, and because of bad macro, you're then just equal in terms of economy or whatever, then it would have been better just to sit back and macro harder. You know?
Yeah.
But here, I did like... Did you scout the Stargate with the Reaper?
I'll have a look.
Yeah, you see it, but I'm not sure if you clicked it. Oh, double Stargate, okay. So, yeah, here, I think you're going with the... Well, that's concerning already. Normally, this is the Bian 60 Marine drop, but you're not getting the reactor on the factory now, it's a bit late, to be honest.
Can you do the 16 Marine drop? Because I feel like it's just... I'm so unprepared with Protoss, I just go... I'll just do this because I know I've got to pressure them. So
16. The interesting thing is the 16 Marine drop was initially done in TVP and then transferred to TVC, where it just worked way better.
That's cool.
That's really cool. It still works.
Yeah, it does feel TVP style, you know.
Yeah.
But then against Z, obviously you can deny creep spread so well with it against many overlords.
That's
pressure them into making units instead of drones. And see this little lag here from me getting the Marines. I mean the medivacs because the reactor was late.
Yeah, exactly. the medivacs take 30 seconds, so you're still okay. But normally they could be 10 seconds earlier, so you can leave the base exactly at the 5-minute mark with Stim then completing. Or is it even... No, wait. Or does you... Now I'm a bit... Let me check. When do you get the drop out?
I thought he was doing double Stargate. Did he cancel one?
Yes, he did. That was
what the
I don't
I
maybe
see the second one.
maybe, yeah, maybe he thought he didn't build it and forgot about it. So he plans down a second one, and then he's like, "Oh wait, I got you know
but when remember, when this guy's like platinum or something." It could
When Zerg for example goes second Baneling nest, and you're like,
"Yeah, it is."
No.
And as well as like I don't know, it's horribly inefficient, but maybe if I snipe the Baneling nest, they still got the Baneling nest.
Yeah, but
it's pretty bad.
So I do see you went for one supply drop because you didn't constantly produce supply depots.
Yeah. Hurts by what is it like 270 minerals?
It was 217 hots in Lotf. It's only 200, but still.
Okay.
But still, it's
200 minerals. It's
it's 2 times 1 supply depot. So this supply depot is now 300 minerals heavy.
Holy! I lost 15. That's crazy.
The fun part is you're not that far behind because he did macro so bad.
Yeah.
Imagine a good turn throwing down a Nexus at the 4-minute mark, now being on 45 probes. That would be horrible.
Yeah.
You also get 2 turrets, which is very strange.
Really
No, what you want to do against, like in any matchup, even TVC now, is at some point, if you have a base like this, the factory is in a okay spot, but normally you want to have supply depots there as spotters, so that you don't get dropped.
I've seen that like a long time ago from like a day 9 video called How to Win 90% of Your Tier End Games or something.
Yeah.
And it was about putting supply depots there so you have vision of like warp prisms and drops and shit like
exactly,
that.
Exactly.
And that was exactly my thinking with the factory because I'm like, well, it's
smart, sure, but production should be safe in the main base. If you are not producing in TVP, normally you use the factory either for tanks or for widow mines.
Right.
So it depends. If you go tanky vex against Protoss, this can it can work. But I when do you go widow mines? If you play against Phoenix Adept, for example, you don't go tanks.
No.
That you go widow mines. If you are against Stalker, widow mines can work, but tanks are a bit better. Against Disruptor, I feel like tanky vex are really, really good. But it's more expensive. Tanky vex and Liberator takes more time, so you will be behind in upgrades potentially.
Right. Which one do you go personally? Like, do you blindly go one, or do you literally wait until you see?
You should never go blind in any matchup.
Yeah.
You should also never play just the matchup on autopilot, or you should try to play also the map, and if possible also your opponent. So this map, for example, I have on Vito as a Terran, because it's just...
I vetoed it after this game, I think.
Good decision, yeah.
Now. I hate this map.
Yeah, it's not good for Terran, in my opinion.
It's so long. And there's a gold base that Zerg can take so far.
And Protoss as well, with Photon Overcharge, it's not that easy to pressure it.
Yeah. I get this really lucky drop-off, because he doesn't have his, you know...
His Mothership Core, here, yeah. That's... what did I want to say? The maps I vetoed as well, and you get this work.
Yeah, I hate that map, I've also vetoed.
It's not good for Terran as well, especially in TVP or TVC, it's just not good. And the last map I vetoed is Darzan Station, because that map is just too wild.
I vetoed that as well.
Yeah.
Those are all my vetoes now, but this one wasn't on my vetoes, and I had like Galactic vetoed. Reasoning being the third base is ridiculously easy to take.
Yeah. You lost quite some SCVs. It's nice that you find so much damage with your drop.
Yeah, if I didn't, I would lose.
It should have never happened, to be honest.
Of course.
No, normally you drop with the 16 Marines, and unless you are beyond, then he just defends with PO and Adept Warp in, and he's fine. That's how it goes for my games most of the time. But he hadn't. I don't know if you did. No, he had no Mothership Core. Like, wow. And
you'll see that kind of shit in Platinum. Like, because I'm used to being a Masters, so when I face these people, like, I feel a bit elitist, and then occasionally I'll lose, and I'll be like, well, he friggin' beat me, so
yeah.
I can't beat him, dude.
No, basically, what I saw is your micro and decision making is not that bad. Focus firing, as you said, you like to micro, apply pressure,
I
be
love
active.
Micro.
Yeah, yeah, I saw that. So that is definitely a strength you have. But
thank you.
You sacrifice a lot of map awareness, maybe, or my macro, and so fundamentals, which just hit you harder than you hit your opponent with your incredible micro. it's like with one hand you are fighting your opponent in a duel, and with the other hand you stab yourself in the back all the time while you're beating him up.
I try and stab him harder than I'm stabbing myself.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things I could reference there, but
yeah.
This game is very weird though. This is like
it is really weird.
It's incredibly weird.
At some point I thought, wow, is he really coming back? Are you gonna throw? Because you just lost like 10 Marines and a Medivac to nothing, basically. And you have and you have a Liberator there, but it's okay. So with the macro tactics, first of all, this barracks positioning of the third barracks is very strange. what you started initially with your base layout, I like that. So that you have your production lined up in lines, like vertically. This is really good. So you can go up from the starport, 3 more barracks, for example, then have 1 or 2 tiles space. It really depends. If you, between your first and your second barracks, the reactor and the rex, there are 2 tile space, like 1 supply depot. And
do you see how I mess up the line there?
You
I was trying to
just
line that
completely
one.
Random, bam, bam, bam.
Normally, it's not this like this. To be honest,
okay.
Most of the time, I do the lines, but this was horrible.
Yeah, no, I see that a lot. It happens. If you're now, for example, if you would micro at the third base, hit this natural, and then you have to drop the rex. Okay, but at that point, you had nothing to do. You know, there was no pressure on you. You didn't pressure. So take the 1 second.
Should I be spending this energy on mules right now as well, or nah?
You did scout him. At least you should have. So you should know. Okay, no DTs are coming. Definitely mule. Definitely.
Okay.
And there is a trick. When you mule, I just saw Pig doing a daily, like 50 minutes video upon this. When, where to mule. And what he was doing...
I saw the video, I just didn't watch it. It was called like an open cut way to mule.
Yeah, and what he does is he double mules all the high mineral fields with the 1,500, which normally are near the command center.
Yeah.
Always double mule those in the main base. And what happens then is the main base will run dry at the... So both minerals, the 750 and 1,500... should run dry at the same time, so you can just lift the main towards the third base and take the fourth base as your third command center. So you save those 400 minerals, but still are on the bases, if you don't need the gases, of course, which if you play tank, liberator, and upgrades can be difficult. If you play widow mines, liberators, then you have the gas to do this. To come back to the base layout, you have one supply depot between the reactor and the barracks at the starboard right there.
Right.
So you could fit one supply depot there. If you play tanks, then that is correct. If you play widow mines, I would just have one tile, like the sensor turret is one tile. Because it makes it easier to defend against zerglings, banelings, zealots, or even ultralisks, because they can't attack anything there. And it makes a base trade scenario. Tanks will deal more damage because units have to funnel through an even thinner bottleneck. If you have tanks, widow mines are way more better. Liberator can cover more space because if the rest is buildings, then Liberator can cover more space.
Yeah.
Those are small tricks.
You're saying a supply depot worth of space.
If you go tanks.
Like right there.
Yeah, between those two. So that's the space you want to have between your buildings if you play
not
tanks.
All of them.
No, just to get a pathway out of the main base.
Right. Now I get you.
Yeah, and if you don't play tanks, just one tile for Widowmines and such. If you have just one tile and you play tanks or Thors, they won't get through, and then you are like, where's half my army? And then you go back, there are five Thor, no, I needed them, no. Which can happen sometimes as well.
Yeah.
And to come to the supply depot trick, do you have the idle worker button?
Yeah, but I don't use it.
You will start using it right now.
Right.
You start... Okay, in the first like 5 minutes, you don't really need that trick because you are still aware of when to produce supply depots. You see it. There's not much production going on, but as soon as the second base,
I get the trick. So what you're saying is, after the early game, when you make a supply depot, don't shift click them back.
Yep.
And then just use the idle worker button.
You will see. You will see. It will pop out. If you have a look for it.
Yeah, it does pop up when I see it.
Yeah.
I don't usually have idles because I always shift.
Yes, you should, but not with the supply depot worker.
I see what you mean though. It's a pretty neat little thing you could do.
And then you are constantly producing because as soon as the supply depot finishes, you have this SAV. On two base, you have two SAVs, and if you take your third base, you have three until the 200 mark, and then you stop.
Yeah.
So, and that works quite good for me. If you get used to it, it really helps. You are most of the time not supply capped. What can happen is that some aggression throws you completely off the build. But that happens. That's just how this game goes.
Yeah. Pressure makes you feel pressured and
yeah,
etc. Like I didn't get combat shields. I love it.
Interestingly, up until Master, that happens a lot to Terran player if they just open up with one tech lab for Stim and after that combat shield. If they open up two tech labs like at the same time, then they don't forget it. But one
it makes it very like open to your
What you want to have as Terran. I don't know how many drones do you want to as Zerg in total. On four bases. Is it 72 like, or 80 or?
Not 80.
Not 80.
Like 76 or so.
76.
That's what I usually aimed for. Was okay. 76.
So you have eight gases and four.
When you have to start like sacrificing them.
Okay. Yeah, I just read somewhere you have eight on gases, like eight gases taken, and three bases full saturated, and the fourth base with eight worker, so half filled saturated. But it depends on the game, I think.
Like a perfect situation, I'd say.
Yeah, so that's 80 drones as Zerg, basically.
Wow.
And as Terran, you have 66, unless you need the fourth base gas for potentially Ghost Liberator, then you have 72. And you just mule the fourth base.
So basically you take all the... Cause well, what I was finding as Terran is, like, compared to Zerg, I wasn't spending any gas because I was just going bio all the time.
Yes, yes. In Heart of the Swarm, it was like you could have just five gases taken to get the upgrades and later on take the fixed gas if you need Thor, for example, in TVZ. Now with the Liberator, you need all six gases because in most matchups, TVC as well at some point, you start using the Liberator against the... Ultralisk or against Protoss, against basically everything, and then you need the gas, so you go up to six gas there.
Right. We should look at another replay, I suppose.
Yeah. What you can do, I don't know how you set up your control groups.
I can tell you. It's pretty... So basically, I found these control groups, and they were for Terran, but yet I've used them for Zerg for a long time.
Okay.
And I found them from Apollo back when he did the revamped tutorials for Wings of Liberty.
Okay.
There was one and two for army, like one is the main army, two is a specialist group, three for all your command centers, four for all your production, and you just tab through it. And five would be for your NG bays and your armory.
Okay, I have a layout that works better for me.
Yeah.
Which is 1-2-4 for army, because I
start...
Yeah, you have to think about you have a main force, which normally is nowadays sometimes even divided because you have widow mines or tanky vags. So you need two control groups just for your main army.
Yeah.
Like bio and then tanky vags, for example. Or bio, mines, tanky vags, or ghosts. And then you have the drops, which you need to have on a control group as well.
Mm.
So if you start, for example, dropping here and here and pushing here at the same time, you have 3 to 4 army groups already, which you might need, because switching on the minimap and selecting the units is takes longer than just clicking one button.
It does.
So I have 5 for my command centers, as well as the Ghost Academy, the Armory, the eBay, and the Fusion Core.
And you just tab between them?
Yes. The good thing is, because you have the eBays and the Armory in the same control group as the command center, you see when the upgrade finishes. Because you are every 17 seconds producing SCVs. You're constantly having an eye on it. And if you forget about combat shields, you can also put the tech lab into this group, or maybe into the barracks group. It depends. Just as a reminder, if you get used to it and then you can forget about it again, I don't need having the tech lab in a group anymore, but it could help you just getting used to it to produce it, and then later on you throw it away again out of the group.
Yeah.
So that's so I have 1 until 6 basically. And that's okay reachable with the left hand. 7 is already hard, so but 6 I can reach quite well. It also depends how long your fingers are. I have quite long fingers, so that's okay.
6 is okay. Any further than
6 yeah, it's getting difficult. I don't even like H for hold position. I would need to relocate that somewhere else. But I don't know. Are you using camera hotkeys?
Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 4 for your bases, I assume.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
No, I very much so love camera hotkeys from going to hatch. Like, it helped me get injects perfect.
Okay, so you did injecting with camera hotkeys?
Yeah, because I know there's the backspace method, and then there's
With the next base. But if you have a macro hatch, then sometimes, and I know.
Yeah. I like the camera hotkeys because I just my body and my brain just kind of got used to every this many seconds press this again, and I just did, you know.
Yeah, so I guess I don't know. Did you open up? No, it wasn't gas first. So at some point, let us go back. But because I think that SCV is too much, you should fire up the command, the orbital command immediately.
Did I make it on 20? Because I aim to make the orbital on 19.
Ah, look here, here, bam. No macro. I don't know why, but you're not for like 5 seconds. You're not producing the next SCV.
This is what I am happy for, because she's learning as well.
Okay.
And I have her for this because she does this, but worse.
Okay, so here you have it.
Look,
you are. See? I don't know where you are. Where are you currently? Okay, you are on to. I need to produce the barracks now. But you have the minerals. It lines up, so we can queue up the next SCV. It's okay.
I have like 230.
You see.
I'm still making it.
And now you make the refinery before the SCV. You're like, no, I don't want to have any worker. No.
Yeah.
Okay. No, that's that. On 19, behind. You get the on 19, you get the orbital command.
I've never had this issue with probes attacking stuff because I was a Zerg.
It's so annoying.
What do I do?
You can just pull one SCV, and if you are too late, you need to pull 2. Otherwise, one of your SCVs just dies. I don't know why the SCV.
As soon as it happens, pull one.
Yeah, it's as soon as you see it. So you should, if you are not, which you currently aren't, if you are not stacking worker, like you see your worker aren't stacked at your closest mineral patch left, one worker, the closest mineral patch there, then you can have a look at the ramp and just be like, okay, because you just need to click SCV button, then you can watch the front. But yeah, if you see it or if it happens, it should be enough time. I don't know exactly why the SCVs only have 45 HP. In Brute War they had 60, which was so much better, in my opinion.
Yeah.
You can produce the command center on the low ground. There is.
Yeah, I did that because, okay, I remember this exact moment. I was like, okay, he came in and he left, so he doesn't, you know, look at his vision.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't see anything.
Yeah.
I was like, ha, he doesn't know if I'm going for a 1v Solin or something.
Okay, okay. But, he does know. No, he doesn't. Ah, he didn't scout the gases. Normally, a Protoss would scout your gases, and then he knows. There is no one base all in for Terran out of one gas, which works, unless it is proxy Marauder Marine with concussive shells.
Yeah.
That's the only all in that can work against Protoss, which is really strong, by the way.
Proxy Marauder Marine with concussive shells.
Yes, so you can proxy two barracks and have one at home, which delays the push a little bit, but then it doesn't look suspicious unless he counts your SUVs. Because you have just one gas, the barracks, the first is in time, or quite in time, and then you have two proxy barracks, one without an add-on, the other one with the tech lab, and you just crank out Marauder and Marines. I think you can go for a reactor as well at home. It depends. I just saw it once in GSL on I think it was Dusk Towers. And it really wrecks Protoss. Because most Protoss rely on one adept, photon overcharge, and a pylon for the first 4 minutes. And it hits like at 3:30. So they have one gate to defend, and that's it. If they don't scout it, and if you don't run into the photon overcharge and stay there for 14 seconds, you win. Basically.
That's crazy. I'm not going to rely on that, but I'm going to try it because it sounds hilarious.
Yeah. Interestingly, your Reaper dealt 100 shields to the Nexus instead of scouting, and you could have gotten two probes so far.
It's because my macro is so bad. I have to focus. I have to, with Terran, it's something I've never had to do, is I've had to really, I actually sometimes individually click buildings to make units like that.
Okay.
Because I have to focus so hard. And I'm always unsure of myself. I'm like, if I make units out of this one, I won't be able to make an SCV. Or if I make units out of this one, I won't be able to get a...
Now, I can't
get a starport, right? I can just afford a starport, but with the starport, I now can't queue up two Marines and an SCV. So I have to now choose between two Marines and an SCV.
You have... It doesn't line up as perfect as like the third wheel, just bam button now make. That's right. You have all those tiny interruptions in your production the whole time, which you just need to overcome, and always focus SCV. So if you have to decide between Marines and SCV, make the SCV first.
Yeah.
It mines stuff, which makes you money, which is good, you know. What you could try to work on is going into a custom game and try to hit specific macro timings. Get a build order and play it to get just used to the macro. And now you are, because you're switching races, and it is difficult to get the new timings, the new units used to that, the mechanics, and the macro, which is a lot at the same time. So I would break it down into pieces and just try to macro. Get the 60 Marine drop build order and try to hit 60 Marines, 2 medevacs, and stim at the exact 5-minute mark without skipping SCVs. Bam. Try to hit...
So can you do this build against Protoss? Because I've just been doing it.
It is possible. You just need to have...
Is it recommended?
It's not as good as versus Zerg.
Yeah.
But it can work, definitely. You will hit at the 5-minute mark. So you could hit now.
Well, what do you mean hit as in get to the base?
You could like move out. Okay, you could move out right now. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
so you hit the timing, bam, you move out right now with 60 Marines, which you hit quite nicely. Stim is a bit late, but it's okay. If Stim hits at 5:30, finishes, then that's okay. Normally, Protoss gets the third base at the 4-minute mark, depending on there.
He was 40 seconds late.
He was going for a 3-gate and Dark Shrine, and he was completely freestyling. That's not a good build at all.
No, it's not.
But normally,
I suppose every Protoss just goes, I want DTs so bad.
Yeah, but normally Protoss goes one gate, Robo if it's standard, maybe Twilight Council or Stargate for pressure, but 4 minute mark, Nexus and Pylon. And it will finish at right, 5:10, 5:15. Yeah. Which is quite when you hit with your Marines and your Medivac, so you can still.
Should I attack it? Should I like kill it?
Yes, that's what the build is about.
Ah, that's cool. That's really cool.
You can.
I really want to do that. That sounds amazing.
The thing is, you can try to drop, but there's Photon Overcharge. Like, look at all the pylons, and here's Warp. Okay. Oh no, you don't want to drop there. But the Nexus is new. It's fresh. He will have maybe
maximum is one pylon.
Yeah, one pylon and a mothership core, and depending on the game, maybe three adepts. But there is, if he has the pylon to the left of this Nexus, you can go to the right, be out of the photon overcharge, focus fire the adepts.
Exactly. Really small. And it lasts, what was it, 14 seconds? Did you say?
14 seconds, 7 range, 30 DPS, 13 damage each shot, which is 0.72, I don't know, seconds every shot.
That's a pretty crazy knowledge you got there.
Yeah, I know a lot about time. Did you know Banelings have attack speed as well? 0.59? Or 5.6? They have an attack speed.
I didn't know that.
Attack speed, that's so strange. Banelings also get +5 attack for against buildings for each upgrade. Melee attack upgrade.
Yeah, I heard of that though.
That's so wild.
That's always nice.
No, but with the 60 Marines you could drop where the Photon Overcharge isn't, focus the adepts, kill the Nexus. Go back, gather with 4 medivacs, just macro behind, and go in with 30 marines and 4 medivacs.
Would I keep making marines? Would I not make marauders?
You can start making marauder, but if he goes blink stalker, then you should start marauder very early. If he sticks with adepts, you can, depending on the game, stick with marines for a bit longer. The problem is marauder are expensive. If you start Marauder before making your third command center, the E-base, and your 5 racks, then it delays everything a little. Marines are cheap, fast, and you can deal damage with them.
Right.
So in large numbers, Marauder are awesome against Adepts and Stalker, but you can go up to 5 racks with 3 tech labs, 2 reactor. And if you have this, then you can go 3 Marauder and 4 Marines at a time. And then add Reactor Widow Mines. And if you are up to 6 Medivacs, you stop doing Medivacs. You don't need anymore.
And you make Libs anymore. Libs, yeah.
And don't ever.
When do I take my third? Like, I have a feeling I should take it like now.
Bjorn takes it between 6:30 and the 7 minute mark. He starts making the third.
Oh, wow.
I thought as well, man, I need to get it down right now. But no, he's like, I am on 2 barracks, 1 starport, 1 factory. That's okay. I have marines and medivacs. I deal damage. I'm out of the map. I go double upgrades. That's fine. And after, like, he's really at 6:30 taking the third base and just then starting the third barracks after it. Which seems so. I can't do it. I will die. I need production, man. I need something. But he's just so good.
Wait, what did you just say about the barracks?
The third barracks, he gets the third barracks after the third command center is in production.
At 6:30?
Yeah, after 6:30. Yes!
Serious? Yes. Every game, or is that just a fluke?
No, I...
Maybe he forgot.
No, I can look it up.
That's absolutely insane.
Let me check.
And then again, Bjorn is inhuman.
Yes, he is.
It's crazy.
So,
but he's definitely my idol, like... he's ridiculously entertaining to watch.
Yes, definitely.
He's
so
by far the most entertaining.
That game of New Gettysburg, if you skip to the 40 minute mark is good. 40 minute mark, and then just watch it. How he then continues after the drop. Later, after the session, of course. Then you can see how he does it. I was like, I need to go on to 5 racks before the third command center. I need units. It doesn't work against Protoss. interestingly, it works really best just stick with 2-1-1 unless you face a gateway explosion like 8 gateway, adapt glaives all in or something like that. Then you need more production.
Some bunkers or no bunkers?
Yes, bunker. Definitely.
But can't they just go past your bunkers?
Yes, but then they are stuck on the ramp if you lift the supply depots. And then they are so boned.
Right.
Because you have the best, you have a 360 degree concave. Eventually, maybe Widowmines as well. And he just shaded in. He should never do this.
Yeah.
So he won't go. If he goes past the bunker, depending on the situation, he will just straight up lose. It's also fine to have, if he goes, like 2 bunker at the front, or 1 bunker, like, right next here, between the ramp and the orbital command, 1 bunker at the gas, or maybe even in the mineral line. It doesn't matter. So that he can't shade behind the mineral line to adapt and be annoying.
Yeah.
And
but
one,
is that only if they're going gateway explosion, or...?
If it's adept, if it's Blink Stalker, a bunker in the mineral line, you don't need it. Normally, you don't need a bunker in the mineral line at all, but if you feel safe with it, better get it. It doesn't hurt you much, to be honest.
No.
As long as you constant produce units, that's the macro issue again. But
Yeah. But it's that, nice, like, since I've had... I actually had a coaching today, actually.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And... So the thing about my TVP, it's actually my best matchup.
Okay.
I actually don't lose very often with it, and that's kind of against the rules of coaching, because when you coach someone, whenever I coach people, I always ask, "What's your worst matchup?"
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
where can you improve? Where can you
that matchup.
Improve the most? Yes, of course.
Yeah. And then that'd always go up a league instantly, every time.
Mm-hmm.
And that was how I like felt good. You know, like that was my success.
Yeah.
And but I just love TVP. Like TVP, every single time I face a Protoss, I'm really happy.
Mm-hmm.
I just really love this matchup. I think this matchup is beautiful. Like just gunning down these really armored, like, you know, I don't know, something about it, and all the harassing potential and how you've got to be really aggressive.
Yeah.
Zerg is fun too, but it scares me. Zerg terrify me as Terran.
Yeah, I understand why.
They absolutely terrify me. Okay, so this is me when I'm going up against Zerg. Okay, I have to do lots of damage, but they could just decide to make lots of units, and then I can't. But then they're behind economically. But they'll still get out ultras.
Yeah. That's...
And now I've got to have a million, like, all these units that I don't really like. I'm pretty bad with liberators. Not bad, but new to them.
Because
I played mostly in HOTS. And I don't. I'm okay-ish, kind of bad with Tankovac, but I've been using it in TBT because you kind of have to.
Yes.
And, you know, Thors, like, I pretty much never use ever because
no,
I try and
not.
Make the game end before the late
yeah.
game.
Thor are so also not that good, to be honest. If you're not playing mech, you don't really need Thor. Also
okay.
not really against Mutilus. You have the Liberator now, which is... More mobile, cheaper, faster, better.
Yeah.
It's yeah. The Thor is...
I like Liberators, like, using them. They're quite strong.
It's cool if you have, like, 8 and or 10 of them with the range upgrade, and you just cover the whole screen in Liberation zones, and then you are saying to the Protoss, come at me. Come and then slowly, and then you unseach
the
back line, three of them to the front, push forward with the Widowmines, and Protoss sits there, has an observer, sees it, and is like, oh my goodness, no, he's coming closer and closer, no!
Yeah,
unless they have Tempest, they are so boned.
Yeah, and if they have Tempest, now it becomes... I've honestly never faced Tempest, like, in my life.
Okay. Tempest can like be shit. Difficult. If the Protoss goes up to Tempest, you have a timer. You have two choices then. Either you attack fast and commit, which can result in a very bad trade, or you go back and try to drop multi-drop to free supply to get Vikings out. And
right.
then you need Ghosts as well, because he will eventually go into Storm, and Tempest, Storm... is so scary to face. You can't engage into storms, but he's chipping away your army with that's the thing. Most protoss go up to 12 tempest, which is idiotic. They don't need to so many. 6 tempest is enough.
Yeah.
It is enough to snipe liberator. Yeah.
With a giant range. You know?
Exactly. And then they have the oracle. They tag your army. So even if you snipe the observer, your army is tagged for one entire minute. So what do you do? And that's really difficult. So tempest can be very bad to play against.
I like to end games. Like, I like aggressive games. I like, you know how bio is really good in scrappy type scenarios?
Yeah.
Because they can heal, mm-hmm. so they're very efficient.
Yeah.
I love making those situations happen, if you know what I mean.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, like, I like it to be really aggressive. I don't like games where it's just both players sitting back and macroing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, no, then I mean, Terran is definitely the right race for you. It has a lot of potential. Like, you could, if you have this situation now, I mean, we can watch a little bit further what you're gonna do now. You're loading up, flying across the map. Sadly, he did see it with the adapt.
Yeah, that was very unfortunate.
But yeah, you can drop now. You decide to drop and you get the Nexus. Like,
oh, I did do that.
Yeah.
I could have gone on the right-hand side away from the pylon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, initially,
but the pylon was very far away from
initially, you wanted to drop his main, and you could have hit like 10 seconds earlier if you just would have dropped here, stim in, kill the pylon, kill the Nexus. Lift up, go back. That's the thing with Terran, you try to, if you don't find damage, don't commit. Just lift, boost away, heal up, and stim in 10 seconds later again. Against Zerg, for example, you know it maybe out of first hand. If they stim in, kill a creep tumor and 2 circlings, lift, go back and stim in 10 seconds later, and you miss an inject because of that, that's massive damage.
Yeah.
You don't see the damage because you didn't lose 10 drones, but losing an inject for 10 seconds is quite significant. And if that happens 10 times or 3 times, and every time you lose a creep tumor, which you need to remake, which is less energy on your creeps, which queens, which is less transfuses, then
remember, like, unless you're in Grandmaster or High Master, like Master 1, they might not even replenish them sometimes, you know?
Exactly.
Like, they might just forget, like, oh, I just creep spread, and they might, you know, oh, it just doesn't click, because when you're under pressure, you forget stuff. Look at this weird fighting that's going on right now. I'm definitely not macroing. I'm microing.
No, the position is always quite bad. That's.
Look at that. That makes me want to cry, the zealots.
Yeah, it made me more cry that you had 4 marines at the ramp attacking 1 immortal instead of just using all marines to focus fire it down.
Yeah, no, that part, I just wasn't even going to say anything about that. Look at this! I could pick up that immortal on the right-hand side, and that would be an immortal gone.
Mm-hmm. So the damage you dealt was good, but you could have done this damage without losing the marines. Just imagine that.
I was probably crying about the DTs in my base.
Yeah, getting 3 turrets in the main base because I don't know why.
I was really sick of DTs.
Yeah, DTs are really annoying. That's true.
I think this is the one I lose, isn't it?
Could be. I'm not quite sure.
Because I don't have enough energy for a scan.
Yeah.
And he's behind and he's bad at macro.
Mm-hmm.
So, and his unit decision making, like his choice of units, is rather.
Yeah.
I don't think it's, you know. What do I? The other coach today, because I got coached on TVP.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
he said that there was like a time where you blindly get. Turret on an engineering bay, and then at 5 minutes you make 1 turret in each mineral line.
Yes, you need to scout.
Yeah.
So you can't if you go blindly for the eBay. Sure, if you scout the DT shrine, you're fine. If you don't scout it, that's the difficulty, right? So the DTs can hit at 5:15, I think.
And that's crazy.
It's if it's 2 base. If it's 1 base, it can hit at 4:15. But you can.
But one base is very easy to scout.
Yeah, especially 1 base. You just lift your natural up to the main base, bunker up, and you're safe. So that's not a problem. But two base,
I've never lose to one base.
Yeah, you shouldn't normally. I mean, there are some one bases which are really wild. I just faced one base disruptor drop, but he never committed. Yeah. And I was scared. I didn't scout it. You know, I found the Robo proxy, but the Robo Bay was at home in his main base, which I didn't scout. So I didn't know what was coming. You would assume you see the proxy Robo, okay, Immortal drop. Of course.
Yeah.
What else? Because it's one base. And he never committed, took, it was a galactic process, the gold base, and had an observer on my ramp. And I moved out with Marines and tanks. He got one disruptor shot, blow my entire army. I instant left because that was GG.
Yeah.
But normally you shouldn't lose against
very,
one
very
base.
Like clown situation, like ridiculous.
Yeah. But with the DTs and the eBay, you know, the eBay takes I think 29 seconds and the turret 17. So in total it is like 45 to 50 seconds. When the DTs, if the DTs can hit at 5:15, so you would need to start maybe a bit earlier, let's say 4:20. Get the eBay and get one turret.
And it is, you know, it helps against oracles. It doesn't completely nullify them.
Yes.
Oracles are pretty common.
It is enough to have one turret and spare one scan. You don't need to build two turrets at this. So against Oracle, you normally have, if it's not a proxy Oracle, just expand into Oracle. Then you have one turret in time and a Widowmine at the other base, normally. If you scout the Stargate in time. But yeah, two turrets, one turret, stuff like that is okay. So he was definitely right there. It's not really blind. You need to scout how many gases did he take, what units does he build, is his mothership correlate? All those are indicators. And what I just did look up today, because of those DTs, I thought you would ask something like that, is you can count the pylons to know if it's proxy or not.
I used to know how many pylons it was.
Yes, but the Legacy of the Void and changed. Yeah, and
I just
rewatched. Yeah, it was like two pylons in Hordes at the time with the Reaper, and if he doesn't get a third one, then you know. Here it is, three pylons at that stage of the game. If you look at his supply, good, he's not the best Protoss player. You should maybe watch the game I linked you. But you see, this pylon he got now. Where's his other pylon? He got a fourth one. Now it's three pylons. Now it is three pylons. Because and you see he has like 16 supply left, spare.
Yeah.
So three pylons, two nexus. One nexus is 15 supply, two nexus are 30. Each pylon 8 is 24 plus 30 is 54 supply. And if one pylon is missing at this time, like 3:30, then it is proxy. It has to be proxy. Because he will now proxy then the Twilight Council. He might even had already gone with the proxy Twilight Council now. And will throw down the Dark Templar Shrine.
Yeah.
Right
now.
You
can throw down the Dark Templar Shrine now.
I think so, yes. I think so.
Yeah, because he's had a Cybercore for a long time, and he's got 300 gas now. So
yes.
He could have had the Twilight Council before.
And if you... So you can scout the pylons. The problem is he has, most of the time, one Adept out and Photonova charge. So it is... You don't want to lose the Reaper, because the Reaper tells you, is he getting a Nexus up or not. But if he isn't getting up a Nexus at the 4-minute mark, maybe
like a proxy. If he didn't have a Nexus at the 4-minute mark, my reaction would immediately be
eBay.
Engineering Bay and mass units in base and lift up, you know.
Exactly. So I would wait like 10-15 seconds. Because sometimes it's just late, and then you commit to something which you don't need to, and the timing gets really crisp. But if you float on the eBay at 4:15, as we late just thought about it, it's still enough against the Dark Templar.
Yeah.
So yeah, the Reaper should stay there. or maybe SCV or Marine if you lose the Reaper. But normally the Reaper, the Reaper should go into the main base at around 3:30 to know what kind of tag is he going. And you should not lose the Reaper and park it to see is he going for a third base. If not, go in. If you don't see anything, scan the other base. The thing is, with the Reaper, you need to not only scout, but remember where are his pylons. So the scan you might need to throw doesn't miss anything.
Yeah.
So always scout where are his pylons. Where could he potentially throw down his tag to scan it?
Yeah.
The worst thing can happen, you see nothing, and then you have just to play it blind. Mm. But what you can do then as well is have one SCV there, one Marine here, and one Marine here. So you know when he's moving out, you should see the warp prism in most cases if it's coming across the map, because it won't fly on the edge of the map all the way around, because he wants to hit the timing, it's gonna go straight through. So you should see it if it is a warp prism play. And then you can pull back, you know it's a warp prism, you can pull the Marines in position so he can't drop, and this gives you another 15-30 seconds time, because he can't drop on pawn of Marines. He needs to find another angle. It's like the same if you drop. If you drop and he fires up two overcharges, you just pull back and go somewhere else. And that's the time the Protoss gets, you get as well, if you have the vision. And that's important for TVT especially, but also for TVP. For TVC, yes, I would say so as well. But in TVC, normally you are the aggressor, so you don't need those spotters as you're constantly dropping on the map and the Zerg has to defend.
You're pretty much always, like, even against Protoss, I'd say Terran is still more of the aggressor, you know.
If the Protoss isn't all inning or doing an attack, yes.
Yeah.
What's really annoying is if Protoss go adept play and they shade in four adepts in each base at the same time. I saw so many pro games just end because four adepts in each mineral line killed like 50 SUVs in total within 1 minute. And that's versus adept play, it is indeed very difficult, because you need to split your army in order to catch up with the shades. And if he cancels, your army is split. But if you don't follow, he just let it go through, and then you are not there to defend. So adepts, I still think they need to do something about it. Yes, it just feels unfair to have a unit at two places at the same time.
Yeah, especially mostly just because they're a core unit as well, and they're very strong on their own. To be very strong just as an A move unit, and then to be able to be in two places is pretty bizarre.
Yeah.
But I suppose Protoss is there's the whole argument of they're not winning every pro game or blah blah blah, you know? They're actually the least played race in StarCraft.
Oh wow.
By a lot. By a huge amount.
Okay.
They have 40 people in GM, and then Zerg has like 75, and then Terran had like 70 or whatever.
But interestingly, I think we have still in BlizzCon this year so far only 3 Terrans, the rest is Zerg and Protoss, with Protoss being the most player.
I'd say Terran, I'm not going to say, oh, they're the hardest or whatever, because they might be, but they might not be. But I'd say they are, I don't know, they're the most, finicky, would be my word.
Okay.
They're a lot less, you've always got to do special stuff as a bio player.
Yeah.
You have to do these fancy tricks, you know?
Yes. Okay. Is there anything else you want to ask or having covered shortly in the rest of time we have now?
Maybe just a question or two.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the other coach recommended the Bion build.
I would recommend it as well. You can also play the Polt build, which is Widowmine drop into 3 medivac stim, but it hits later and the Protoss might just be able to defend better. On the other hand, you are more safe against Oracle entities because the Widowmine drop hits right when he throws down the tag, so you can scout with the medivac.
Right.
That's the payoff.
The only thing I've had with the Widowmine drop so far is every single Protoss so far seems to just completely expect a Widowmine drop every time.
Yes.
They always like everything else works better for me so far, mm-hmm. but obviously I'm in like pretty, you know, mid to low levels currently.
Yeah.
But I don't know, they just expect it. Maybe every other Terran at my level currently does it. So they have an observer mm-hmm. sitting over the mineral line usually. This is like one okay. of the only guys that, you know, didn't.
Okay. Yeah, for me it is, if I go with the Widowmine drop, they most of the time pull the worker. Pull one yeah. here, sacrifice, and that's it. But yeah. this Widowmine drop is not there to deal damage. If it does,
it's
nice.
There for scouting.
It's there for, that's the weird part. You drop a Widowmine for scouting. You see his army which he needs to pull to clear it. And with the Medivac, you try to scout his tech. So if you don't have the Reaper, of course, anymore. If you still have the Reaper, then you can go in with the Reaper. You can go in with the Reaper and the Widowmine drop at the same time. Yes. Widowmine drops can, I feel like also against Zerg, Widowmine drops can work in the mid to late game. In the early game not so much, but in the mid to late game,
yeah,
they just work really well. Especially if you have in TVC the drilling claws upgrade.
Yeah. Well, TVC looks like it's going to be going the way of Ling Bling Muta into HOTS, basically. It's just going to be HOTS soon.
Yes. I myself went back to play 2 Reaper, 6 Hellions, quick 3rd Command Center, because I don't find any damage with the 60 Marine drop.
Yeah.
At all. The follow-up with the 2 tanks can work, but still, most of the time I feel like I'm just even now. And going for the HOTS style, as I call it, with the triple command center and the Banshee into Viking, double eBay, I feel like I can hit a really good 2-2 timing against Zerg nowadays.
Yeah.
And also it's anti-meta, so he goes heavy Ling, like 30 Zerglings to defend against the Marines with 5 to 7 Queens. And his hatchery starts right exactly with my 3rd command center. My Hellions can kill all his Zerglings, and my push will be so strong, especially if I don't lose the Hellions.
I was actually considering that, because I've played a huge amount of HOTS compared to anything else.
Yeah, me too.
And I love HOTS. I really love HOTS.
I still think HOTS is the better StarCraft at the moment. But I hope this will change.
As do I. Legacy's not complete to me at all.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
HOTS is complete, and obviously Wings is complete, but Wings is a bit iffy. But I think HOTS is a beautiful, beautiful game.
Yeah,
but,
I think so too.
Yeah, it's been a struggle for me. So when I was a coach, I'll just say this, I guess, because mm-hmm. you're running out of time. But when I was a coach, I coached HOTS, and I mostly did Zerg high level, mm-hmm. like low master or below.
Yeah.
And I did the other races Diamond or below.
Mm-hmm.
And it just sucks. Like when Legacy came out in the beta, I was actually living off my coaching.
Oh, wow. Okay. Okay.
So I coached a lot of people.
Okay.
Huge amounts. I love coaching. I love mm-hmm. being coached, you know.
Nice.
It's really fun for me. So when Legacy, the beta came out, it was so different. It was the biggest change I've ever experienced in like a game.
Mm-hmm.
And I just like kind of rage quit.
Okay. So, okay. Yeah, I had a lot of struggle as well with Legacy of the Void. It took me a long yeah. time to get used to it. Now I like it. It's still StarCraft 2 and it's good,
yeah.
but
yeah.
I'm not there that I say, wow, StarCraft 2 awesome, like it was in HOTS. That feeling isn't there yet, so but we
feel like, well, obviously they added in just so many tools for harassment. They changed it. They kind of took out all-ins being, you know, you can't all-in constantly. I feel like HOTS mm-hmm. all-ins were better.
Yeah, they were more viable. So
that's my opinion.
I think so too.
But yeah, like in Legacy, they really made it more, and this isn't necessarily a bad thing, but they made it. It's all about taking bases entirely, which is what StarCraft's about, really. But
mm-hmm.
they made it, like, only about taking bases.
Yeah.
Like, that is, it's about taking bases, and it's about harassment. That's what I feel like Legacy is.
In HOTS, it was like, yeah, denied it Zerg's 4th base, do it, it's good, with your timing. But that was with the timing, and now I feel like you're constantly dropping, seeking damage, and
yeah.
it's more challenging, yes, but not particular more better, no.
Yeah, yeah. And I feel like everyone's economy is just, even a worse player will still have a crazy economy just because mm-hmm. everyone's economy in Legacy.
Yeah.
You know, just because of the worker change. Like, mm-hmm. I just feel like it's crazy.
Yeah.
Everyone's economy is just nuts all the time. And units mean less in Legacy, 100%.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a single unit in like Heart of the Swarm means more because of the start. Like, the start is so huge. Huge.
Yeah.
Units in Legacy. But anyway, that was good. This was good. It was a different style than the other coach, which is always nice to, you know, have, you know.
Yeah. Like, I hope opinions. I hope it helped you. So.
Yeah, of course. I think you're a good coach, though. You
oh, thank you. That means a lot to me. I'm just getting used to coaching, so.
Yeah, to be a good coach, like, I think my biggest thing, what I always tried to focus on, was just when people ask questions, and the people that you coach are going to ask a million questions. Mm-hmm. It's mostly just going to be friggin' questions. It's not going to be you showing shit. It's mm-hmm. going to be improv kind of questions. So maybe, like, as you knew I was going to ask about the DT stuff, maybe try and find out what they're going to ask about. Mm-hmm.
That's why I want to have the replays and a short chat before the lesson, you know, so I can prepare for it. That just makes it better.
Not a lot, but quite a few people I always found. Like, I always asked for five. I didn't ask for like 5 to 10, but a lot of them were like, oh, I don't have any that are good of recent, especially low league players.
Yeah.
Low league players do not have replays available unless they are not going to be low league for very long.
Okay.
The ones that did soared up to diamond immediately.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the ones that didn't, just replays are, you know, that's the secret, you know, that's how you can cheat and get higher marks in your rank, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Anyway. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it was good. I wish you luck on your coaching thing with the website and stuff. The website looked pretty good, so I've never used one for coaching. I never thought of it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just cast sometimes for SCV Rush. They do weekly tournaments for lower leagues as well.
Yeah. Heard of that.
And they are now sponsored by Gamer Sensei, and then I was like, well, give it a shot, why not? And so far now it's working quite nicely, so
yeah. I like the idea of making it a bit more professional-esque.
Yeah, me too. It's good.
Cool.
I didn't do any notes now, sadly, so
that's all right. You recorded it, didn't you?
I did. Yes, I'm still recording.
That's huge.
I will upload it. You can watch it then.
Yeah.
Whenever you feel like to just rewatch it. So just for a sum up, the depots as spotters in your base layout macro with the SCV idle worker trick for the supply depots.
Yeah, I'm gonna use that.
Then DT timing. Go in with the Reaper at like 3:30 to see tech.
Be a lot more focused on the scouting with the Reaper going in.
Yes.
Back in.
Try not to lose the Reaper. So you need to scout the pylons without being near them. That's the difficulty there.
There's the whole thing of like sometimes it's like I could completely get this probe, but it's like 50 minerals
don't.
And a little bit of build time.
Don't.
Or dying to double Stargate.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, but don't sacrifice the Reaper. Sometimes I am like, I want to bait a photon overcharge with the Reaper, and if I successfully do it, I feel good. The problem is, my timing attack, the 60 marine drop, hits so late that he has enough energy for two more overcharges at this time. So it doesn't do really anything, but still it feels nice. But don't lose the Reaper. The pylon can two-shot the Reaper, which is so absurd. I would love to have the photon overcharge only deal 29 damage. Would also be enough for every other unit.
Yeah.
But
pylon photon overcharge has always been pretty strong.
It's painful if you when you go up the ramp or anything or jump up the cliff and then there's the PO and shuts down your Reaper and you're like, wow, now I'm blind and I have two Marines and what is he gonna do? Because sometimes when that happens, he just moves across the map with the probe to adapt the mothership core, throws down three pylons on your ramp and it's like, pylon overcharge. And that's really bad. If that happens.
I've only had that happen once, but and I defended it, but that's because players you know, the whole ELO thing, low mid ELO. Yeah, they could do something that's perfect, but they could execute it so horribly.
Right.
But they just don't play as much is the biggest thing.
I think so too. So if you work on, I would really say just load up custom games, get used to Terran macro now, hit your timings, like get the Beyond Build order played as long as you feel like, so that you get used to it. Hit the 100 supply at the 7 minute mark. That's a good timing to hit. And at between 9 and 10 minutes, depending on how the game goes. Sometimes 8:30 even, but that's I think that's too early. You can be maxed out. 9 minute to 9:30, you can be maxed out.
At 8:30, you'd have to not. There would be no pressure.
No pressure and command center first. Yes, I know, but it is possible. But I would say Beyond Build and then 9:30, maxed out. That's a solid timing.
That'd be pretty impressive. Well, I'd be happy with that.
If you can do this like 5 times in a row in custom. Then go back to ladder and try to focus on that for the first time. I know you want to go out and micro and harass and such, but if you have more units to micro, it will be even more fun for you.
Yeah, it'd be easier.
Yeah. So that would be my advice now for you to improve.
Sweet. I'll jump onto that. I don't have much time tonight because I've got a lot of uni stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It's annoying, but you know, gotta do what you gotta do.
Yes.
Okay, sweet as man.
Okay, I don't know if you need to confirm anything on Gamer Sensei, if you just look there or if you can rate me.
I'll jump on just to make sure because I might have like a confirm when it's done type deal.
Exactly, something like that. I don't know yet. It says for me it's completed now and it's okay and I got everything, but you know, maybe there is something you can do, rating or anything. Just give it a look.
I'll definitely have a look. Okay. I like to use this once when I'm master again. Mm-hmm. Hopefully I'll get high master with Terran at some point.
You definitely can. But,
I've got holidays coming up, so I'm going to...
I see.
I've cancelled this small trip I was going to do that I've been doing every holiday, but I've done it so often now that I'm kind of bored of it. Going down to parents.
Good.
So I'm going to practice a hell of a lot, play a lot.
Yeah.
Good time.
If you have any short questions, you can hit me up anytime. I'm glad to help.
Sweet.
But if you have anything big, like another 1 hour league, then you would need to book it, of course.
No, that's all good.
I will just link you my YouTube channel where you can then see the...
I actually subscribed to it because I was like, it's probably going to upload it.
Success. Thank you for that. Okay. Good. Awesome. With that said, I will... hang up, wish you a very nice day, best of luck,
cool.
And maybe we see us on ladder in a nice TVT someday.
True that. Okay, sweet as, see you man.
Bye.